doesn't get any bigger than what you're about to witness on TNT and WCW's own Monday Nitro. A quick word to log on to WCW.com and click on WCW gear. A brand new look at our merchandise website where you get the latest official merchandise worn by your favorite WCW superstar. That's only on WCW.com. And now, the drama unfolds for the great wrestling fans watching on around the world. And for this capacity crowd here in the Idaho Center in Boise, where Kevin Nash, Sid Vicious, the DFG, the Dog-Faced Gremlin, Rick Steiner, come to the ring. And Brain, there's been a lot of questions about the alliance with Sid Vicious and Kevin Nash. Not too long ago, they seemed to be at each other's throats. But together, along with Rick Steiner, they make up three of the most dangerous, most talented, biggest men in our sport.
Well, take Kevin Nash at 7 feet tall. He's cool, calm, collected. He's always in charge of what he does. Sid Vicious, 6 feet nine, 6'10". He should be put in a mental institution. He's crazy. Steiner, this man is just dangerous. You saw what he did to Scott Hudson. These are three very, very dangerous human beings walking this earth.
And what's at stake here if Sting, Hollywood Hogan, and Goldberg can win the six-man tag? Then Kevin Nash not only gets a shot at the world title, which we already knew, in Sturgis Saturday night, but he will, in effect, put his career on the line in that match as well. So, call your friends. Get your sodas. Sit down in front of your big screen. When we come back, Sting, Goldberg, and Hogan come out. They're standing along the back row. Anywhere, concession workers are coming out. People around the merchandise stands are trying to find a spot to watch this one. And the very best seat in the entire world is the one that you have at home. Here he is, the man who really did the right thing this past week. In a meeting this week and a follow-up meeting this weekend, he had won the control of WCW, the presidency, if you will. But he gave it back to the executive committee to name a new president, which I understand they will do. And then J.J. Dillon puts Dusty Rhodes in charge of the championship committee. Sting, a champion through and through, with or without a belt, in the ring, teaming with two of the biggest stars of the 90s, will be coming out here in just a few moments.
Well, you can't pick a winner here. It can go either way, real quick or awful long.
Megadeth, crush them rings out.
Imagine the team. Imagine the team of Hogan, Goldberg, that man right there, the singer. The man's on his way.
In the past 2 years, not even 2 years, since September of 1997, Goldberg has changed the face of pro wrestling. The win streak, the domination, the power.
The other day, Bill Clinton said special word to WCW. He wanted to play golf with Goldberg. But Goldberg would have had another commitment. The President of the United States wants to play golf with this guy.
Everybody wants to be associated part of Goldberg. Impervious to pain, you cannot hurt the man at all.
Everyone here is ready. They're on their feet. Goldberg rules. That's right.
Now Hollywood Hogan has come out to complete this superstar trio. This is going to be a collision of epic proportions. Not only so much on the line, you talk about being in the main event on WCW Monday Nitro. Brain?
I'm just watching Steiner down there on the floor.
And you, get them standing. Many of them wearing yellow in their own.
The red and yellow is back.
The boots, the ovation from the people. He's different. He is different.
Yeah, that's right.